I'm very joyful for everything. I want to be employed and I want to work hard, show what I have and do what I can to satisfy people and to make people feel the same thing I feel. I want to be a chef, so I don't want to look where I came from. I want to look where I'm going.
Desire is to be a b-ball player. That's what I dream about, think about, just playing basketball for life.
My favorite memory is when I get to come here. I was just happy in a way I couldn't explain it.
Main the Streets is a place where lives are changed. Basically, we go out to the streets, invite kids to know that their situations and the place where they are doesn't define them. We learn basic English, maths, Bible for at least 2 or 3 years, and then we take them to the skills center where they learn, you know, whatever skill they choose to learn. I think it's only God who can do some of the stuff that I've been able to see.
I love being around kids because when I grew up, I didn't grow up in a community or in a family that someone like would want to play with me or carry me or go somewhere with me. It kind of makes me feel important and kind of erases my bad memories when I was a kid. I grew up in a slum called Madari. I officially started living in the street when I was 10. So it was very hard for me to grow because I would see a lot of killings and a lot of corruption happening down there.
Most of the kids go to the streets because they feel it's a much safer and better place from being mistreated, from being abused, from being unwanted by those who would otherwise be caring for them. Once they get on the streets, you know, they realize, you know, it has its hierarchy. You know, you use drugs, you know, both to sell and for yourself, to shield yourself from cold and, you know, any other things, you know, that would happen. So the kids just have to endure with the knowledge that for them it's a little better than being home, as hard as that may sound. So
glue is a drug in Kenya people use to sniff.
For glue, they mostly just sniff. It's going to be in a bottle and they'll just inhale it. It's not like they're going to drink it, but just once you sniff glue, you start hearing or seeing things. I used it once and I never liked it. I felt a sound. I felt I was being called. And I tried to follow that sound. And I tried to follow the person who was calling me. And I ended up landing in a sewer.
Some people use it for keeping their mind without memory, thinking about anything. They just feel that the life they are living, they are comfortable the way they are living.
Once you sniff glue, you know, you kind of like resistant. So, you know, it may be cold, but because you're sniffing it, you feel like you're warm, you feel like you're hot, you don't feel as much.
Sometimes we would sleep hungry. My mom would stay home, but my dad was going to Isli. Then we will beg some money and he will come with some money, not a lot. Then we will be able to eat from there. I came to Meats when I was 13 years old. The first time I went to Isli, I was happy because we went and we were given food. Every day, if we go there, we go to shower. So initially, I was very happy because I had my own bed and my sister had her own bed, so that made me happy.
For someone like Amina, she would have ended up being one of those girls who are like either prostitutes or being sold into some kind of, you know, slavery, you know, on the streets. Her dad was not able to walk. It was a struggle for him to fend for them. You know, some people tell him, if you want me to give you money, then, you know, let me sleep with one of your girls. And then the man would say, no, let's keep going. And it was getting to a point where it was really difficult and they would have ended up, you know, being abused in ways that wouldn't be nice. When they came out here, you know, she just concentrated on their studies, did so well, and Amina is become a person who's even be able to serve in the church.
If you could change something about the world, what would you change?
Me, I will change guys. The men that don't respect ladies and the ones that rape girls, that's what I would like to change. And the guys that beat up their wives, this is what I would want to change about the world. Yes.
Recently I was very depressed because like I lost my first job, and so I was like I didn't have anywhere to go, so I was very depressed. So I decided to come back to meet. I don't even know how long I was going to stay here. I don't know when I was going to be asked to leave. I think one of the things that have worked for me is that I've learned like to volunteer, just helping out and doing things that make me feel that I have a purpose to live, you know.
The people I can look up onto, they are not many. I've seen other people failing. The most challenging thing in me is to be a Christian. I'm afraid of being called a pretender.
My fear is to fail after meet.
I was a street kid. Now I'm a changed person. Are they going to accept what I am? Those street kids are bad, but if you help them, you show them love to them, they'll become good. Like all the street kids that have become to meet, they really change. Like even a street kid can change.
I think the best way to express love just by listening to someone and spending time with them, listening to their stories.
When someone is telling their story, to a larger extent, it creates a healing. If there were ills or negative things that happened or one went through, the more you talk about them, then the more you like, you know, the more you feel a lot being enlightened, and it reaches a point where you tell them with more joy now as someone who has overcome, as someone who has, you know, who has seen the, you know, the importance of these negative things that otherwise weighed you down in this, you know, that are past.
God used me living in the street. He was kind of like shaping me or molding me to be like a living testimony.
I've seen things happening, like I've seen people dying, I've seen people getting healed, I've seen people like be strong when they were weak. To the people like who are seeing this, who are going to see this, and things like they have no hope. They never know what they can do until they try.
Something that I would like people to know about me is that me too, I would like to help people.
I don't stick just in Kenya.
I want to be like Jesus, what he did.
I want to work in the media, and also want to be a dad of two kids in the future.
I think it's what keeps me going. Like, you know, if I can see just one other child be able to fend for themselves and stand on their two legs, then I praise God for that.
Ask your question again, please. How far I want to go.
Thank you. Thank you.